But like, Tana, you're completely irrelevant. But I feel like Tana changed once she met... Hi guys, it's been Alex, and this is gonna be a why I don't support Tana Mojo anymore video. This is gonna be very controversial, I'm well aware, but I'm just gonna explain my side. So as you may or may not know, Tana and I used to be really, really close. Like, I found her, like, end of 2015-ish. And her and I developed a relationship really, really quick. I really liked her at first. Her and I really get along. And, so her and I, like, we really get along. We had a lot in common. And I really connected with her, like, through the internet, which is weird, I know, but, like, that's basically how our relationship started at first. And then, like, fast forward, in January, she followed me for the first time on Twitter, and then she unfollowed me probably about 2 years later, in the same month, but, like, a different day. And I don't support Tana anymore because she unfollowed me from Twitter. Now, any normal person would be like, okay, they unfollowed me, I'm just gonna move on with my life. However, since Tana still follows me on Instagram and has me on Snapchat, something is up, right? And she never looks at my stories, like, she never reads my Snapchats anymore. She used to read my Instagram DMs, but she never, like, responded. And if she did, it'd be, like, a half-assed response. And I get she's a busy person, I get it. But when you're in the public eye, and someone like me who has been here since the beginning, who literally used to put a roof under your head when I would watch her videos and every time her ads would pop up, I would put a roof under your head and you're ignoring me. Like, I don't give a fuck who you are. You are not Taylor Swift. Like, if you were Taylor Swift, I could see why you're ignoring me. But, like, Tana, you're completely irrelevant to Taylor Swift. So, like, you have no reason not to respond to my DMs. I get you're busy. I get that. Completely get it. Not denying that. But you're not Taylor Swift. So, you don't get a million messages a day from fans because you only follow 1,000 people on Twitter. So, like, it just goes to show, like, I don't get it. I don't support her anymore. And, like, I worked my ass off to get her follow. I'd always tweet her. I would always tell her to follow me. None of that would work. And the one time I actually got it, I don't remember how I got it. I think she finally just followed me again. And, you know, the fact that she didn't follow me, it is what it is. I don't care. Her and I, we were really close. Yeah, whatever. But if you're gonna ignore someone who literally put your ass on the map, then, like, you don't do that, you know, especially because she knew who I was, like, and I have really high standards when it comes to YouTube channels and who I watch. You really have to, like, make me entertain in order for me to subscribe to her. You have to do something to your fans or treat your fans a certain way for me to subscribe to. And I feel like Tana had that in the beginning, but I feel like Tana changed once she met Shane Dawson. I am not the biggest fan of Shane Dawson. I don't really care for him. I think he's really like any other big YouTuber out there. Like, his videos are very mediocre in my opinion. Like, they're just like everybody else's. I mean, yeah, he adds his own spins and twists to that, but I just don't like Shane Dawson. I'm really not the biggest fan of him. That's no secret if you've been following me on social media. I mean, I kind of do keep it in a lot of the times, but for those that personally know me, you know that I don't really like Shane Dawson. You know why? And I feel like, actually, probably around this time is when I was going through a lot 2 years ago, and I went to Tana and Nessa and Shannon. However, I still support Nessa and Shannon. Like, they're, like, my best friends. I literally talked to Nessa, like, last month. I love Nessa so much. Like, I can go on and on about how much I love her because she's such a good person inside and out. So is Shannon Rose. Like, okay, so I'm going to tell you why I subscribe to Shannon Rose and Nessa. So, Shannon had a really fucked up childhood, and she turned her life around for the better. And I really, really think anything is possible because of her. And Nessa isn't the one who thinks she's all that. She isn't the one who is in it for the money, who is in it for the views, who is in it because of the, like, subscribers. But they are very genuine people, and I don't know, like, it takes a lot for me to subscribe to a YouTube channel. These are the people that I'm subscribed to on YouTube. Shannon, Nessa, Taylor Swift, Ariana Grande, Mikey Barone, Bryce Hall, Eden, and I think, like, that's it. I'm very, very picky on who I subscribe to. I don't subscribe to, like, Jeffree Star or, like, James Charles. I don't care for any of them. But, like, you know, like, I could go on a whole ranting spree about how I don't like certain YouTubers. If you want that video as a rant video, let me know because I will definitely do it. Like, I could go on and on all day about that shit. By the way, these are all real CDs. I don't remember if you knew this or not, but hold on. I actually have an example to show you. Hold on. Maybe not, though, but hold on. I'm gonna look. So I used to have pictures like these up as, like, the CD art but I don't have this physical copy. I have the digital copy of this. If and when I do get the physical copies of Danger Showman and Poppy Computer, I will probably do something like I do with this and hang them up like this, where I can just take it out on this end of the CD. That's probably what I'm gonna do. I don't know where I'm gonna put them though. That's probably what I'm gonna do. So with that being said, on Amazon or eBay, I'm probably gonna put her posters that I have signed from her. I'm probably gonna put her shirts and her, like, I have a tour sweatshirt that I got from her. I have a gold bleach and tone shirt. That one I'm probably not gonna sell because the design, like, the gold is fading off. So you can't really see it as much as when I first got it. So I'm not gonna be able to sell it. And if I do, I'll probably sell it for, like, $10. And I normally got it for, like, $40. So you get, like, $30 off, which is really good. But yeah, so I have another video coming up soon about, like, the Maddie series. It's gonna be included in that series, so stay tuned for that. And don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Turn my bell on for my notifications, follow me on all my social media, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.